What's up, everyone? So a lot of you guys probably are trying to get into botting, trying to start botting, and making this video today mainly to help you guys set up for every Supreme drop, but also the TNF drop that is happening this week. Supreme has been pretty dry the past couple weeks, and we finally get something that's kind of cool. I really like the olive colorway and the black colorway that's dropping this week. And yeah, another reason why I'm making this video is because if you guys are getting into botting, I think Mekpreme should be your first bot, mainly because it's not as pricey as all the other bots, like Prism, like Cyber, like Kodai, Knight, like something you can't even get. Mekpreme is very accessible. You can buy it almost everywhere. You can rent it out. It's a really easy to use bot, and it lets you master everything that goes into botting, such as monitor delays, proxies, keywords, webhooks, AYCD, farming your Gmails and stuff like that. It gets you everything. And I know a lot of you guys probably don't even have a lot of credit cards and debit cards and whatever cards. So the thing is, if you don't have a lot of profiles, you don't even need to buy proxies. You can run on local hosts. So you can run up to like 6 tasks on local hosts and they'll pretty much hit every single time. So to do the math, if you guys get 6 BOGOs and 1 drop, and each of those BOGOs go for about 100 profit, you pretty much make up half the bot within 1 drop. And typically there's usually 1 or 2 BOGO drops, and there are a couple North Face drops, like 1 or 2, and then some collabs, some denim jackets usually do well, allowing you to make up that initial cost of Mekpreme by the end of the season. And yeah, if you don't really want to use it, you can always rent it out, which is fairly easy. But yeah, besides that, let's get into the video. So the first thing you want to do once you have Mech open is make sure it's up to date. So the version right now is 0.8.15, but that'll likely change usually before a Supreme drop if it's actually like a hype release. But after that, you want to import your profiles, or if you don't have AYCD or Essentials in order to convert your profiles back and forth, or any tool to help you, all you have to do is go to profiles and you can add billing. So say Steve 1, first name and last name, email steve@gmail.com, street address, I'm gonna just put something random so you guys don't know my address, apartment number. Usually apartment jigs work on Supreme. Personally, I use apartment jigs, so I would just do apartment B, A, B, something like that always works. Phone number 443, something like that. Phone number usually doesn't really matter. You can put something random in and it'll still work. Just use your area code just in case. Zip code to whatever. City, let's put Washington, DC. Region, so US. State, let's put DC, country, visa, and then card number, whatever your card number is. I think that's 4, 4, maybe like one more number. That, and then your CVV. And you add billings. So that would be your first billing profile. You can use it. The profile name would be Steve1. Proxies. So to import your proxies, all you have to do is add proxy. Add proxy, whatever list you have, save it. And then you name it whatever it is, and you save proxy. Then you'll have your proxy list. And settings, all you have to do is put in your webhook. That's pretty plain and simple. All you have to do is go into Discord, whatever your success channel is, then create a bot and copy the webhook for it. The last thing you have to really do is to set up is to create your capture harvesters. So if you guys don't have AYCD, Kodai Essentials, or Kylan, all you have to do is really, let's say we open one, and it opens one of the captures. I'll show it right here. All you really have to do is click Gmail in order to log in. And once you're logged in, all you have to do is watch videos on Gmail. Like, you can watch these videos in order to up your capture score. Just leave them running overnight. The only thing with Mech's capture solvers is a lot of times you're not able to watch like 6 videos simultaneously, but if you don't have a lot of tasks, you're able to just watch like 3 videos on 3 harvesters, and that should last you through the drop if they're all one clicks. So you don't really need AYCD if you don't have a lot of profiles, but if you do, I would recommend farming as many Gmails as you can in order to have one clicks. I haven't used AYCD autosolve yet, mainly because I just import the Gmails into Mech. But you can use this route if you want to. I just think having your emails in Mech is a lot faster than sending it to AYCD and then sending the key back. But yeah, this is pretty much all you need to do before you actually create tasks and start it for Supreme. So yeah, let's close these out and let's go to tasks. So in order to create a task, you're gonna need the keywords. All you have to do is add tasks. Let's say the name of the task. This week we're going for the TNFs, so TNF Parka. Profile, let's say the profile I want to use is Steve1. So for keywords, you have to put it in a special way, whatever the item is named. So if it is the North Face Parka, all you have to do is plus North plus North comma plus Face comma plus Parka. So this way it goes directly for the parka, but you do have to set the category to jackets. Color, if you're looking for a specific color, you can put in the color. So let's say I do want the olive colorway, I'm gonna put olive. If I want to go for black, I'm gonna put in black. Sizing, I usually leave it random because pretty much any size I can get, I'm happy with. But if you do want a specific size for personal, what you want to do is just click medium, small, large, extra large, and you can go specifically for those sizes. Item quantity, you usually have it set to 1 because you can't really check out multiple parkas, multiple things, except for if it's like socks, I think, or like one of those small accessories that allows you to buy multiple. But you don't really do anything with that. The best modes to run are browser safe, browser normal, but always have some APIs just in case they start working. Usually for hype drops, browser normal will get you through. What I do is have like 8 tasks that are browser normal, and then the rest of my tasks, about 15 of them, are API modes. You don't want to run too many tasks on Mech because it just can't handle it. Your PC can only handle maximum browser task, that's right here, minus 16, but I only use half of that. So let's say browser normal, checkout delay 0, and have retry on failure on, because if it fails, it won't just stop the task, it'll just keep trying until it can check out. So for proxy list, I would recommend running about 4 to 5 tasks on localhost and using the rest of your tasks with proxies. So let's say I do set this one to localhost. Your localhost is usually the most reliable one, because if there is proxy protection on, if there's bot protection on, typically like localhost will still get through. Doesn't matter. Browser normal will bypass bot protection typically, and localhost will bypass proxy protection. So if you don't have a lot of profiles, you can run up to like 6 localhost, but I wouldn't recommend going over 5, and most likely one of them will at least check out. And then the last thing, I guess, is to have release mode on if it's a release, and setting your monitor delays. I usually set it to 600, lower than the normal ones, just in case. And you should always be looking at the time for Supreme. So you want to start your browser normal, browser safe tasks a little earlier, because they are Chrome profiles being made, like Chrome like actual Chrome users being made in order for you to check out. So I usually start them between 4 to 5 minutes before drop, just so it could open the browsers and be ready and start monitoring. But the API modes and all the super modes, I'll start literally 30 seconds or 45 seconds before drop or 10 seconds before drop, depending on the drop. If it's more hyped, I'll start it a little earlier, but if it's less hype, I'll just start it 10 seconds before. Usually they'll go through, no hassle. If you are looking for the keywords of the week for a specific item or anything, you can always go to supremecommunity.com and go to drop lists and see this week's drop list. So we have the Supreme North Face Summit Series Outer Tape Seam Shell Jacket. That's a really long title, but these titles are usually correct. And what you can pretty much do is take some of the keywords from it, put it into Mech, and go for specific items that way. I usually go to Supreme Community to see the sellout times, the prices, in order to see what I'm going for, and also determine what keywords I'm using. But if you want a detailed setup guide, not really a detailed setup guide, but like something just like recommended by the Mech staff, you can go into Mech's Discord and go to the weekly setup. They'll usually have like a Google Doc setup that has all the keywords that you can look at. So let's see. Supreme Week 13. This is the jackets, this is the keywords, the colors, and the category. So it's pretty plain and simple, pretty easy, straightforward. This bot doesn't take long to set up. Anyone can pretty much use it. If you are trying to get into botting, this should definitely be the first bot you're trying to pick up, because it's pretty simple, really easy to use. You don't really need any other tools. You don't even need to buy proxies if you don't have enough profiles. And the price point during the off season, it being around $700 to $900, can't really beat that. And if you do decide that you don't have enough time for botting, you can always sell it during the season for a profit. So it's not really that big of a deal. That investment is going to come back regardless, as long as you run, or if you buy it during the off season and sell it during the season of Supreme. So yeah, it's pretty much that simple. Keep the delays like this and you'll be able to pretty much check out anything. For restocks, I would take release mode off and run a lot of API modes and browser normal modes. But yeah, besides that, I don't use the data saving mode. But yeah, good luck on this week's Supreme drop. Low-key, I'm gonna be going after the olive and the black jacket for personal, a size large. But I think these jackets will do decently. Maybe not a lot of profit, but at least like $50 to $100 in the beginning. It's not bad, but it's not one of the worst TNFs that's come out recently, which they've been pretty trash, to be honest. So this one's actually pretty exciting to look forward to, and I really want to see them in hand. Besides Supreme this week, we have some other drops. I might make another video this week or tomorrow addressing Yeezy supply for this week. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace.